Ulakut. My name is Melanie Lemire. I'm part of a group of researchers in oceanography, environmental contaminant and health. We work together with communities and northern organizations to better understand the link between the ocean and Inuit health. You may have met some of us in the communities while working with the Bright Project or other ones related to contaminants and all the good nutrients we find in country food, such as selenoneine.
Selenoneine is considered a powerful antioxidant, and some studies suggest that it could also help reduce the harmful health effects of mercury. We found selenoneine in high concentrations in beluga maqtaaq and in Inuit blood, especially among Inuit women. At the Arnuk meeting in Tasiuyak in 2017, we asked people if they had any idea why women had higher levels of selenoneine. An elder suggested that this could be because women often eat the maqtaaq from the beluga tail, which could be high in selenoneine. In 2019, we took samples from four whales in maqtaaq together with some community members. Our preliminary results show that the elder at the Arnuk was right. The maqtaaq from the tail is almost twice as high in selenoneine in comparison to other body parts.
Mammals. Us humans and whales cannot produce selenoneine by themselves. It can only be produced by some bacteria that live in the water or in the sediment. So in this project, we want to find out why selenoneine is so high in beluga, why it's higher in the tail, and where the animals get it from. Our first hypothesis is that selenoneine could come from what the beluga eats in the ocean. Because fish have very little selenoneine, we think that shellfish or other organisms from the seafloor are a possible source. Our second idea is that selenoneine-producing bacteria might directly colonize the skin of the animals when they touch the seafloor during feeding or molting, or when they travel through the water. We also wonder if selenoneine levels could be affected by the sex, age, or stock of the animals, and also if those levels can be affected by the changing environment, such as ocean warming, ice loss, and changing river runoff. Lots of questions, no answers yet.
In maqtaaq, beluga is an important country food, and we've been working with the community and the Marine Region Wildlife Board on this project for a few years. It is a great place to study selenoneine and beluga because they pass near the shore and the seawater is very rich in nutrients for marine life. The good news is that we have received funding to do this project and find out more about selenoneine. The bad news is that we couldn't come visit you last March due to COVID. That's why we want to discuss what we could do together and also hire some people in maqtaaq. We are looking for people who would like to get involved, for example, for sampling mussels, organizing fieldwork, documenting Inuit knowledge of beluga, or connecting researchers and community members. Maybe you have some ideas too? This project will allow us to better understand where selenoneine really comes from. It will help the community to get involved with science. It will help all of us to better understand the benefits of beluga maqtaaq for Inuit health. If you're interested in participating, please get in touch with us. And also stay tuned for our next video, where we will explain our second project on selenoneine, which tries to better understand its effects on human health.